Are you with us? Are you here right now?
I keep getting chills up my neck all the way up my head.
If there's children in this room with us tonight, is that you in the hallway? If you're in the hallway, I ask you to come in. I invite you in.
Dr. Mudd had met with John Wilkes Booth a few times prior to the assassination of Lincoln. Booth shot Abraham Lincoln on April 14th of 1865, and a few hours later, in the wee hours of April 15th in the morning, Booth arrived at Dr. Mudd's house because he had the broken leg. Dr. Mudd tended to Booth's broken leg, and John Wilkes Booth spent about 12 to 15 hours at the Dr. Mudd house, after which he fled on horseback into the swamp areas to try and make his escape. Dr. Mudd was found guilty as an accomplice to John Wilkes Booth. He spent about 4 years in prison before he was pardoned by President Andrew Johnson.
When we arrived on Friday afternoon, we got there around 2 o'clock in the afternoon, and we immediately set up to start doing interviews with some of the individuals that had been notified earlier to come out and share their stories with us for this documentary.
It was opening up on a Sunday, and I heard voices coming from the kitchen. I walked out there and there was nobody around. So I went back into the shop and continued opening up. And then I heard like somebody was sharpening a knife on a stone. I came back out here, saw nothing. I walked all the way around this house and still didn't see anything. I've heard knives being sharpened on a stone before, so I figured that's what it was. But, you know, we're so remote out here. Kind of, I didn't know what to think.
And we had probably about 25 reenactors up here, hundreds of visitors throughout the day. And I was asked to accompany another group upstairs to the attic. And I was probably up there no more than a minute or so, looking around for the item I was looking for, and a sign that was leaning against the wall slammed to the ground, just out of nowhere. Of course, you know, maybe the vibration walking around could have caused that, but immediately after that, there was a clothing rack that was located behind me. No one was close to it. It was a large rack with docent's clothing hung on it. It would have been very difficult to turn over without assistance. This clothing rack flipped over to the ground immediately, and all of us left the room immediately.
Another time, a tourist was up here in the front yard taking a picture with a Polaroid camera. When the picture came out of the camera, there was a woman in a long dress. I did see that picture. I couldn't explain that. Recently, there's a secretary up in Dr. Mudd's office. It's set up there for years and years. I was giving a tour, and the right side door come flying open. The woman that was on the tour screamed and ran out of the room and hollered ghosts. But in all these years, I've never had that happen.
I was coming from upstairs in the attic, coming down after working membership on the computer. And I saw this lady standing in front of the window, looking out the window. She had a black dress and a white collar. But as soon as I seen her, it scared me. I just went on down the steps and out the house real quick, scared. But you do hear noises at nighttime, things drop and stuff. Next day you go out there and look, and nothing fell or anything like that. And voices you hear. Sometimes you walk upstairs, I don't go through the house at nighttime by myself.
And when I went upstairs to the Booth bedroom, I was telling the visitors that Dr. Mudd's story was that John Wilkes Booth didn't say anything. And the guy kind of, one of the guys in my little group kind of was taken back, and I looked at him and I said, "What's the matter?" And he goes, "Now I understand. When we were outside," he told me, "when I was outside telling him this is probably where John Wilkes Booth and David Harrell had pulled up on their horses, he felt a cold chill and a voice saying, 'You do all the talking.' But it didn't make any sense to him until we got upstairs and I explained that Dr. Mudd didn't hear from John Wilkes Booth.
It was a Victorian Christmas back in 2006, which was in the first part of December. We were camped out front. It was probably about quarter after eight on Saturday night. All the workers were gone, the visitors were gone, and several of us were sitting around the encampment just talking. And one of the candle lanterns upstairs was still lit, and they're just battery operated. And about 15, 20 minutes later, I look up the house again, there's the second one lit in the upstairs bedroom. And a little while later, there's another one lit downstairs. So the guys got the caretaker up to let him in the house. So they went in, took all the bulbs out of all the candle lanterns. And next morning, about 3 o'clock in the morning, I had to get up and go to the bathroom. And I look at the house, and the candle that was first lit that night was now lit again.
But I do feel that it is haunted.
There are things happening in this house, and they sometimes very strange things that can't be explained.
I believe the Dr. Mudd house is haunted.
I believe there's paranormal activity here.
After finishing our interviews, we set up the static cameras on locations that we felt would be good for past experiences to hopefully catch something while we were there. We started our EVP sessions. We did an EVP session in the attic. We did an EVP session in Booth's room, as well as doing an EVP session in the children's room. We didn't have anything happen in the attic, really, that we considered out of the ordinary. Shelley was feeling some cold chills, but we later realized that there was actually an air vent right there behind her on the wall, so we figured that's where the cold chill was coming from.
At one point, while I'm asking a question during an EVP in the children's room, you can actually hear what sounds like steps in the hallway.
If there's children in this room with us tonight, is that you in the hallway? If you're in the hallway, I ask you to come in. I invite you in. If there's children in this room with us tonight, is that you in the hallway? I'm making contact with us tonight. Give us a sign, any kind of a sign, and let us know that you're here. I'm making contact with us tonight. Give us a sign, any kind of a sign, and let us know that you're here.
I don't believe we have enough compelling evidence to tell you that the Dr. Samuel Mudd house is in fact haunted. I do believe that there were some unexplainable events that happened while we were there conducting our investigation. I do firmly believe that it's worth a second trip. There is some type of paranormal activity there, and there have been two confirmed deaths in the house. Could Dr. Mudd still be walking in the house? It's quite possible.
Do I think there's a strong likelihood that the Dr. Mudd house is haunted? Definitely. But I didn't see enough for myself to prove that there's a full-blown haunting at the Dr. Mudd house.
If you'd like to make a donation to our museum, the Dr. Samuel Mudd Museum, you can call 301-274-9358. We are a private museum. We're the only private museum in Southern Maryland, and we're the only museum down here that's 100% self-supporting. Our income is from the admissions, the gift shop, and donations.